my good friend Carrot Top at the Luxor. I've never laughed that hard. I encourage you to go see him.
Now that is some great advice from Raiders coach John Gruden, and we have some good news for you. Now you can go see his good friend Carrot Top as he resumes his show at the Luxor tonight. But before he does, of course, he had to make a stop by more. Carrot Top joining us now. Carrot Top, great to see you.
What a beautiful, I wish I had nice things to say about John Gruden.
Well, I was going to say, he says you're good friends, but did you tell him you're a Dolphins fan?
Oh, yes, he knows all about my Dolphins. We've been friends for a while now, and we text. I send him a daily, I call him a daily Gruden. I'll send him some stupid thing I do on Instagram. Well, and I sent it to him every day. He loved it. But he knows I'm a dog. In fact, I pleaded with him. I said, right before he took the coaching job, I said, oh, we could just find a decent coach in Miami. And he came in the spring and he said, not a chance in hell. I was like,
You mentioned your Instagram. I've been following you for a while now. And I will say, one of the most underrated Instagram accounts out there. You got comedy, you've got your dog, you've got lip syncing, and of course, day drinking. And it's just the best of all things. I love it.
Yes. Oh, good.
I love it. So you're back at the Luxor tonight. I know you came back for a little while during the pandemic, but you're back again. How are you feeling with the show?
Well, you know, it's unbelievable. It's really, I can't believe it's happening. We're actually going back. Tonight's the first night. The only thing different, I think, was since the last time we were there, it's going to be 100 people as opposed to 250 people. So it's 250, it was 250, now it's 100. So the next time I'll be probably doing the show in my car. We'll see, but we're looking forward to it. But hey, we're sold out. Who else can say that?
There you go. It's still a sellout. And I mean, for those who've seen your show before or big fans of yours, can they expect, you know, the same comedy from you?
The style of the show's going to be pretty much, you know, my style, but I got a lot of new jokes. I mean, you got to talk about Texas now being cold. You know, they put a rover on Mars, right? Yesterday. 136 million miles away, yet they can't get a turbine to fix in Texas. Yeah. Houston, we have a problem. Yes.
Very true.
And here's the irony of Texas. Who would ever thought that state would turn blue?
that's true.
See, it's a red state.
Yeah, it's very true.
I don't think my audience is going to get that one.
So how much material are you? I mean, you just look around, and I imagine being a comedian, just there's material everywhere with kind of
the cow's milk will already be, the cow's milk's going to already be refrigerated. There's another joke.
There you go. They just write themselves.
They're just writing themselves. My head's not.
So I got to ask you, though, with the amount of props you use, when there's current events like this and constantly changing, how quickly are you able to make some of these props?
Oh, sometimes I'll make them an hour before the show. I'm famously known for when I used to do the Tonight Show, is I would always I'd make myself write a brand new joke that day when I got there, and do it live on the live television. And Jay would always go, "Yes, maybe I'm going to try it. It's crazy," you know. So that was always my thing. I have to do a brand new joke and be a risk taker, and it always worked. And I remember my friends would always watch and go, "Oh my God, that new one did good." So I'd go find the stuff right. We had a break and run to Target and see if I could find it.
That's so cool. Well, we can't wait to see you back on stage again. Again, you'll be at the Luxor tonight. You're only dark on Sundays, so you're as busy as ever. And I'm really excited for a character.